Hello everyone, in the previous video, we set up a mail server with Postfix and Dovecot on Ubuntu or Debian. In this video, I'll show you how to install and integrate OpenDKIM with Postfix. This is an important step to add a digital signature to your outgoing emails, so that providers like Gmail Outlook can verify the sender, increasing both the reliability and professionalism of your mail server. First, make sure that the Postfix and Dovecot services are running properly on your system. This is a required step before we integrate OpenDKIM. Next, we are going to install OpenDKIM along with the required tools. OpenDKIM is the component that generates the digital signature for emails, ensuring authenticity and improving the reputation of your mail server. After the installation is complete, start the OpenDKIM service and enable it to run automatically at system boot. This ensures that OpenDKIM is always active whenever your server restarts. Next, we will create the directory structure for OpenDKIM and generate a DKIM key. This key will be used to sign outgoing emails. Make sure to replace it with your domain name. Next, we'll create three important OpenDKIM configuration files: key table, signing table, and trusted hosts. Now, let's move into the directory where we will store the DKIM key for our domain. Next, we will generate the DKIM key using the OpenDKIM-Genkey tool. This key will be used to digitally sign outgoing emails. You can change the selector to another value instead. Keep in mind that the selector should not be too long, just short and easy to remember. After running the command, two files will be generated in the directory. .private. This is the private key, which OpenDKIM uses to sign outgoing emails. This file must be kept secure and never shared publicly. -txt. This is a txt record containing the public key. You'll need to copy the contents of this file and add it to your domain's DNS so that receiving mail servers can verify your emails. Next, we need to set the correct permissions for the private file so that only the OpenDKIM user can access it. This is a critical step to keep the private key secure. Next, we will edit the main configuration file of OpenDKIM, OpenDKIM.conf. This file defines how OpenDKIM works and how it integrates with Postfix. First, in the OpenDKIM file, uncomment the logy line. Next, find and uncomment the mode and subdomains lines. Next, locate and edit the socket line so Postfix can communicate with OpenDKIM. Next, add the following lines at the end to define the important configuration files. We'll configure these files in detail in the next steps. Now save the changes and exit the editor. Next, open the key table file. This file specifies which domain will be signed with DKIM and the path to the corresponding private key file. Make sure to replace both the selector and domain name with your own values to avoid misconfiguration. Next, let's configure the signing table file. This file maps your domain or specific email addresses to the DKIM key defined in the key table. In other words, it tells which domain should be signed with which key. Finally, let's configure the trusted hosts file. This file specifies which servers, hosts, are allowed to use OpenDKIM for signing emails. Typically, we allow localhost and our domain. Next, we move on to the most important step, integrating OpenDKIM with Postfix. The goal here is to make Postfix automatically call OpenDKIM when sending emails, so that each message is signed with a DKIM signature. This helps your emails look more trustworthy and reduces the chance of landing in the spam folder. We will add the following sample configuration at the end of the main CF file. I have provided a detailed explanation of each parameter in the description. Feel free to take a look. Finally, restart the OpenDKIM and Postfix services to apply the changes. After restarting, check the status of the services to make sure they are running properly without any errors. Everything is now configured and running smoothly. Next, to complete the setup, we need to create the DKIM record in the domain's DNS. This step is crucial because it allows external mail servers to verify the DKIM signature whenever they receive emails from your server. Copy the entire content of the public key file into a text file on your computer. We will use this content to add the DKIM record to your domain's DNS. Next, make a small adjustment to the public key. Put the entire key into a single line and remove all quotation marks. The final result should be one continuous string in a single line, which is exactly what you'll paste into your DNS record. Next, create a TXT record in your domain's DNS to add the OpenDKIM information. All right. Now let's go back to the server and check the DKIM record we just added. If everything is configured correctly, running the command will return something like this. Everything is now configured and running smoothly. Next, to verify the setup, we'll move over to the client machine and send a test email to check the results. Next, send a test email from your server to two addresses. Check auth to receive a detailed SPF, DKIM, and DMARC report. Your personal Gmail to check if the email shows as signed by and avoids the spam folder. If the result shows DKIM equals pass, it means your email has been successfully signed. This confirms that the public key in your DNS matches the private key on your server, ensuring your email's authenticity and increasing its trustworthiness when delivered. Now, to check directly in Gmail, open the email that your server just sent. If all three show as pass, it means your email authentication is properly configured and your messages are more trusted when delivered. And that's it. We've completed the setup and integration of OpenDKIM with Postfix. If you found this helpful, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, super thanks, and turn on the notification bell to catch upcoming tutorials. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.